Born from Seven Hills, had a slight sophistication. A German immigrant by a generation.
I've never known where that is.
Money held in high, his lack of education. Now he's using it to hide the bruises on her trousers.
Hello.
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 Hello. Hello. I'm Chad Sullins, and these guys are the Last Call Coalition.
And I'm Cecil.
This is Gregory.
Gregory. Okay.
All right.
We do this for a living.
Yeah, let's do this serious. What's up, guys?
You should keep that.
That's Chad. We're his band, Last Call Coalition.
Hi.
We asked you guys to do a bunch of questions for us. And we're going to ask some of those to ourselves.
So we pick the top five.
Yeah. And we're going to ask some of them, answer them the best we can. It's been a long day. We're outside here at the Mercury Lounge getting ready to do a live show. So it could get interesting.
We're still in our underwear.
And we're still in our underwear.
I am anyway.
On the bus.
I tan for this. All right, I'm going to start off. First question. What cover song would each band member like to add to the set? My cover song would be, I don't know, I do cover songs all the time. I don't know, you got one? You already have one, right?
Yep.
All right, Jeremy, give me yours.
Mine is Bob O'Reilly by The Who.
Jerry.
Don't screw up, or we are booing you.
Funky Funk Town, Funk, Funk.
A George Clinton song?
No. I wouldn't pull any Parliament on you yet.
Some Parliament.
Wow. Anything like anything be like those pieces of like YYZ and some Rush stuff and mixing a whole bunch of different things.
So a medley of shit.
A medley
of jams.
Okay, I love medleys. Chad. Sweet Home Alabama?
Beth, my kids.
Beth.
Beth? Can I make him say it?
I ain't saying it.
Yes, we'll get roses. You walk out.
I'll do it.
That's tough. I'd like to do a Pink Floyd song, like Dirty Woman or something.
Shine On, Crazy Diamond, part 1 through 7.
That would be fine.
I would like
By the
to
way,
do a
which
Rush
one's
song.
Pink?
I'd like to do a Rush song, but I don't think we could sing it. Jeremy might be able to. Probably do another Waylon song. I'd like to do the Waylon medley we always talked about.
Running them all together.
Yeah.
Right.
Which, that's a secret. Someday it might come out.
Yeah.
I promised a beautiful young lady we'd do some Johnny Cash tonight. So where's all my Johnny Cash fans at? Rolling around town a little further down the line. Yeah, I found the most
musician be doing if we weren't playing music?
We'd be happy.
I spent a couple years, teenage years, working in grain elevators, and it's more than likely what I'd still be doing. I am in school now, and maybe something will come out of it, who the hell knows, but more likely I'd be a elevator jockey.
I think if I wasn't playing music, I would probably
make the donuts.
Holy I wouldn't still be making donuts. I'd be, I'd probably be working a regular job somewhere, you know, sitting on my butt, gaining weight, and taking vacations anytime I got the chance to.
You're growing, being fat and happy.
True. That's probably what I'd be doing.
You know, the donut
not,
guy.
It's not time for fun facts.
The donut guy from Wayne's World.
Yeah.
Who makes everybody uncomfortable.
Right,
Jay. Honestly, I'd probably be driving a truck or working the oil field or something like that, but I'd quite possibly be in a homeless shelter somewhere recovering from a heroin addiction.
Classic. All right. Yeah, it would be a whole different story. I've been doing this so long.
I'd be in a homeless shelter in LA somewhere.
I mean, I went to college and everything first before I started touring, so I'd probably be working in a bank or something, but I'd be a little healthier, but not happier at all. I wouldn't have these markings on my arms, probably. So it'd be a whole different story.
For those of you that don't know who we are, my name's Chad Sullins. These boys are the Last Call Coalition from Stillwater, Oklahoma. Thank y'all so much for being here. We told you guys we're in a rock band that plays country music, right? Say the bottle is a crutch. hobbling along the day. Your bottle is a crutch, baby, and I've been limping on the days. And I'm going straight to hell, baby. I don't change my wicked ways. And I ain't changing shit, come on. Tie me down or up. I ain't never met no woman that made me settle down, not for very long. I'm leaving down the morning, babe. Might not be back around. It's buried in my soul, and it is. Well, you know this rambling Jones, baby, it's buried way down in my soul. And I'm gonna keep on rambling, baby, until I die. I'll just get old. It's a tale I can't remember. Come on. Ever scratch on this guitar, baby? That's right. Yeah, I know you wanna know me, girl, but trust me, you don't. You don't want to know me well. Oh, that's right.
Don't play guitar?
Don't. If you want to play guitar for fun and sit around the campfire with your buddies and try to impress girls in college, by all means, go right ahead.
But yeah, it just depends on what you want to do. Do you want to have a career? Do you want to just play for fun to just to be that guy in the basement that's awesome on YouTube? What do you want to do? Because I say if a career, be versatile. Don't learn one instrument. See what's out there. I mean, mandolin, fiddle. Yeah, I mean, be that utility guy. Learn everything you can, and just keep playing. If you want to do it, you got to keep playing, man. Because I mean, we see some of the best drummers, bassists, guitar players, singers out there every day, and we just keep at it. I mean,
and as a career, it is a lifestyle.
Yeah.
A lifestyle choice that's very difficult for a lot of people, because if you have family and loved ones, and you know, you better be prepared to sacrifice and do whatever it's going to take. Or
prepare to be disappointed.
And prepare to be disappointed.
Big time.
You
expect
know?
Not to make any money for a long time.
Yeah, if you're getting into this business for the money,
as much as possible,
you're doing it for the wrong reason.
Hopefully, you get good friends.
A lot of guys I know, including myself, do this because we don't want to do anything else. And I've had damn near every job you can have without a college degree, and I've been fired from all of them. So. Almost fired from this a couple times.
Union.
Can't tell me what to do.
But yeah, if you want to play guitar and be in a band, be prepared to make a lot of sacrifices and work your ass off. If you're going to be lazy about it, don't plan on doing it. Let's just stay home.
Remember I told you guys we're going to be playing some new stuff on our next record? I used to drive a truck for a living. Between driving a truck and being in this band, I can say I've probably seen a million miles since birth. I wrote this song in Manhattan, Kansas, about what it's like to be on the road sometimes. What's a couple thousand miles in a few more days? Truck stop profits and broken highways. Honky-tonk angels in a motel haze. What's a couple thousand miles and a few more days? I'm burning through years in gasoline, and I wouldn't trade the world for the things I've seen. I tasted love and I pissed it away. What's a couple thousand miles and a few more days? It's a good life, I can't change my way. And I'm sorry, mama, it's not just a phase. What's a couple thousand miles in a few more days? Burning through years of gasoline, and I wouldn't trade the world for the things I've seen. I tasted love and I pissed it away. It's a couple thousand miles and a few more days. No need me changing now. Not sure that I know how. So burning through years of gasoline, and I wouldn't trade the world for the things I've seen. I tasted love and I pissed it away. What's a couple thousand miles in a few days? Oh, guys. Thank y'all so much.
Where do you see this band in 5 years? Would be the next question.
Bigger. A lot bigger.
Are we just gonna eat more or what?
Let's add an orchestra.
I mean, compared,
let's do a symphony record.
Compared to some other bands, we haven't done much, but compared to some other bands, we've done a lot. Right. And this band has been around for 5 years and has done quite a bit, enough to make us all pretty damn happy. I think in another 5 years, it could only get better.
Absolutely.
And we're getting ready to work on the next album, which
is a full-length record. And that's exciting. I'm looking forward to that. I agree with him. I mean, the work ethic in this band the last 5-6 years has been insane. And, you know, 200-250 shows a year for the last 4 years, and doing almost everything ourselves in the beginning, you know, this last year and a half. It's
still kind of.
Yeah, I mean, we're still doing a lot of it ourselves, but I mean, the last year and a half, we've had a little bit of help from a couple of companies, but for the most part, you know, we're the ones still driving 7 hours to play for 2 hours for $300, so.
Actually, if it wasn't for you guys, the fans.
If it wasn't for the
fans. I don't know what we would do.
Yeah.
Because you guys are the ones that speak for us.
I'll say it again, y'all keep coming to the shows, we'll keep showing up and playing.
And we'll do anything it takes to get to repay you guys. I mean, that's what we're always thinking about. How can we get back to you guys? So,
Stillwater, Oklahoma, there's a man who's considered to be the godfather of red dirt music. A man by the name of Bob Childers. And we wouldn't be sitting up here if it wasn't for him. This is one of his songs, boys and girls. I hope y'all dig it. Where's all my gypsies at tonight? Let's dance with the gypsies tonight. Let's dance with the gypsies tonight. Gypsies are dancing, come on now. Down by the river, let's go dance with the gypsies tonight. Let's dance in a circle around the fire. Let's dance in a circle around the fire. Gypsies are dancing down by the river. Let's go dance with the gypsies tonight. Let's go dance in Tulsa, come on now. I'm This tale's with the gypsies tonight. This tale's with the gypsies tonight. Gypsies are dancing, that's right. Down by the river, let's go dance with the gypsies tonight. One more time.
You know, a lot of bands come and go. What's it take for you guys to hang together and work like you do and be successful like you have been?
Drugs.
Lots of alcohol. No, it's like a marriage, man. If there's no conversation and no trust, then you've got no bond.
Well,
if you've got no bond, then you got shit.
Yeah, this band has two parts. There was the first part with a whole different lineup, kind of, well, one person different. It was a whole different situation then. We didn't talk about anything. It was a whole different, we were not happy.
Yeah.
And then, you know, the part two with Jeremy, the youngest guy in the band, is the guy who was the reasonable guy who had always mentioned, you know, we need to talk about this, we need to talk about it. And when something arises now, we bring it straight out. I mean, they know I'll...
Hey, you're being a dick, stop it. Or you're being an asshole, stop it. Or you're being a drunk, stop it. Or you need to be fucking nicer, you know.
And at the same time, basically, eventually, and I think we kind of fought this for a long time, but basically you have to accept each other for the shittiness and, you know, your flaws and, you know, the good parts, and you just kind of let it be at that.
It's just like a marriage. I mean, absolutely,
or
like
family.
A marriage. It's like
brothers and sisters. Yeah. You're going to fight.
In a marriage, you know, sex is one of the smallest points of being married to somebody. In a band, being on stage is a short time we do, you know. We're on the road 6, 7, 8 hours at a time. We're only on stage for 90 minutes. That's the sex, and you can't just base an entire relationship off sex, because you've got to spend the rest of your time with these guys in a van and in a bus and in hotel rooms, and if you don't get along and you can't talk to each other, then there's just no point.
And we let it all out. I mean, you can ask about the Austin incident.
Oh, we pulled over on the side of the road and tried to beat the shit out of each other.
But that next day we had a show, and they were some of the best shows.
We hugged and kissed and made up.
And at the time, people were like, I've never seen a band. Well, our tour manager at the time, he goes, I've never seen a band that they just dropped all animosity. There was no hurt feelings the next day. We talked it
all the way out.
Ate Whataburger and laughed the whole way
out. Laughed the rest of the way out.
And I mean, it was a big time blow up.
Just like I said, like the marriage thing. If every marriage ended when the first fight happened, nobody would ever get married to begin with.
Right.
Yeah. You got to fight through shit and don't go to bed angry. That's pretty much it.
Yeah.
And drink a lot.
And drink more. Yeah.
I wasn't going to do this song or try it because I haven't played it in a long time, but I just changed my mind. Ain't ain't got a big old mansion, ain't got a pot of gold. I got for you this promise, I'll be sitting by you when we get old and through all the good times, through all the bad. The love that you give to me is the best I ever had. I know we argue, I know we fight. I hope you know you're the reason that I come home at night. Even when you're broken, even when you're sad, the love that you give to me is the best I ever had. Try to think about the good times, not worry about the rest. Not as good when I'm missing you, when you're around. I'm at my best and I think about your smile. And how it makes me glad that the love that you give to me is the best. You listen to the words you're in this song, and I count the miles back home to you. I try not to slow it down. I need you and I love you and I miss you when you're not around. Good times and through all the bad, the love that you give to me is a... Thank you guys very much. Gracias.
Super Dan.
Yeah, yes.
Hey. I see you guys a lot. I've enjoyed it. I watched Jeremy and Josh grow up with my son, and it's been great to see you guys' success. It's awesome to watch and see the entertainment you guys put forth on the stage. I've watched shows, people just come flogging up there instantly because you guys are great entertainers. That comes from the crowd, or you guys, you don't just stand up there and play, you really get into it. You put on a great show, and I see you watch people, and they really love that.
Yeah, and in all honesty, we tried to put on the same show with the same energy, whether we're playing for 3 people or 3,000 people.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, there is a difference. Yeah. I mean, because we'd love to say that we put on the same show for 3 as we do for 3,000, but when we played sold out to Canes that night and had 2,000 people screaming our
singing our songs
back to us, that was an energy that, our goal is to do that every night, you know?
Yeah, it wasn't even
our crowd.
You know? It was just nuts.
But there was so many people there that did come to see us and were singing our songs back to us. And the energy from the crowd, I mean, it's a coexist type of deal. I mean, if the crowd's there and they're loving it, that's just going to amp us up 10 times more. Yep. And the more amped up we get, the more amped up they're going to get.
You just got to get in the mindset where, look, I'm playing music and getting paid for it.
Right.
And we have fun on stage. Me and Jerry will flip each other off. Yeah. We're never mad at each other on stage. On stage, no. We will not do it.
We throw stuff at each other.
We joke moment, around.
You know?
And, you know, you'll see us push each other and stuff. We're just joking around. We're actually having fun because we're either bored because there's nobody there.
Right.
But, you know, every venue we play, they're like, man, you played to the staff and you guys were awesome. Like,
it's
you act like the place was packed. I'm like, well, we're doing what we
love. We got to get up there and have fun for ourselves if there's nobody there, you know what I mean? Because we're still doing what we love to do, whether people show up to see us or not.
Yeah.
You know, and there have been a lot of times in the last 5 years where we've played to the staff or we've played to two or three
it's
people.
It's tough. I mean, it's hard.
And it's
two, two or three people that are pissed that you're
that
even
they're
there.
Mad that we're even in the damn room. You know, I had a 60-year-old woman come flip me off one time and tell me we suck while we were on stage.
She would not stop.
Said that I didn't play anything she could dance to, so she was not.
And it hurts. I hear stuff while I'm playing, you know, they suck, blah, blah, blah. And I try to just block it out. I put my passion into playing harder, faster. I'm going to make you like what we're going to do.
You do find yourself being energetic out of spite. I mean, you can't really help it, but you do. I mean, and it's either awesome and high energy because you're loving there, or you are being spiteful and you're going to show these people.
Right.
You're either going to put it in their face until they love it or until they leave.
And one thing I can say about this band, and it's one of the things that I love, I probably shouldn't, but our fans, it comes down to either we have the greatest fans in the world, which we do, and they love us, or you hate our guts. There's no middle ground.
Yeah.
Either you like our band or you hate our band.
Right.
And if you hate
our band, I don't give a shit.
Yeah, because you're not even into music.
You're right. I just don't care. Oh, well, you know, I don't care. I mean, we've got bad reviews. We've got, you know, all kinds of stuff. And we just got to kind of take it and roll. Because I don't give two shits what a guy behind a computer has to say. He's not the one that's coming to see me play and paying money to buy our shit.
Right. And the ones that do come to see us,
they understand what we're doing. So if you don't like our band, I don't give a fuck.
And it's kind of cool to be that way because we always feel like we have something to prove, and I use that as energy all the time.
And plus, eventually, when success hits, we'll appreciate it that much more because we spent years.
Well, we might not notice it and just keep doing
that. That, or we won't notice it, or we won't trust it. Like, no way, no way people are actually like, this many people. No, they're not here for us.
Yeah. This song's called August Sun. Are y'all ready? Storm. The rain left you clean.
Like that, because that's pretty much what it is. Because I mean, I tell you, when we cut that off, like at certain venues, we've played a couple songs and they sing the song back to you or whatever. We did it last week at the Beckman benefit, and when they were singing Only Girl back to me, I mean, it just, you feel powerful. Yourself just getting,
yeah, they took another verse, like when we didn't even ask for it, they just started going, just, and you're like, going. Awesome.
And it's just this, I mean, it's better than any drugs or sex I've ever had.
Yeah, it's awesome.
It's awesome.
And that's why I do what I do.
It's our brand new single out on the radio, boys and girls. Wrote this song with my good friend, Mr. Josh Lamley from the Josh Lamley Band. Y'all make sure and check him out. Much of a dance floor right now, but if you can find somebody that'll dance with you, this song's couples skate only, boys and girls. Y'all feel free to sing along now. Passengers sing, it's the radio on, and she doesn't know what she does, but when she does what she does, to me, she's a better half of an inside joke, she's the last cigarette when I need to smoke, she's a drug I take to bring me down. Got a smile that'll steal your soul. She swears the Ramones saved rock and roll. She's a lost to my found. Come on, and she's the only girl. Fault is all mine. It's the ultimate sin. She's a better half of an inside joke. She's the last cigarette I need to smoke. She's a pill I take to bring me down. Tulsa, she swears the Ramones say rock and roll, she's lost to my fam. She's the only girl. Kicking ass tonight, thank you all so much.
Conversation with Gib Stones about that inspired Johnny, the song Johnny Met the Devil, at 3 o'clock in the morning. It was actually more like 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning. And I don't remember, well, I mean, the one thing about the conversation that I remember is...
Did he break a guitar that night?
I don't think he broke a guitar that night.
I've seen it twice.
The man is a legend and I love him to death. I'm probably going to get him in trouble here, but it was a long time ago. He was... jacked up on some kind of foreign substance that he probably shouldn't have been jacked up
Peyote.
On. He was talking 90 miles a minute, and he said, man, we got to write a Johnny song, man. It's like, everybody's got a Johnny song. We need to write a Johnny song. And I just kind of talked him through it and let him do what he needed to do. And then when I hung up the phone, the first thing I thought of was Johnny Met the Devil. It just popped in my head. And then I sat there on the couch and grabbed my guitar and wrote that song at like 4:30, 5 o'clock in the morning.
What made you want to make a song about like robbing a liquor store and stuff?
I thought to myself, okay, well, how'd Johnny meet the devil? And I got to thinking, like, you know, how many stories do you hear on the news about these guys getting jacked up on meth and coke and going to robbing liquor stores and convenience stores and stuff like that?
Meth is a good way to meet the devil.
And so, you know, he goes in to rob this liquor store and his gun jams and the liquor store owner shoots him in the face. You know, just seemed like something, it seemed like a good story, so I just kind of went with it from there.
And it actually sounds like a real story, like something you might read in the paper.
Right.
It's child friendly.
So there you go, the story behind Johnny Met the Devil. While you're on drugs. Not that I do drugs or anything, I read about it in a magazine like everybody else.
candied up his nose. His head was empty and his heart was closed. Yeah, Mary just came along for the ride. But help me out now. The devil. Yeah, tiny met the devil for the price of the bullet. Yeah, tiny met the devil for the price of the bullet. Well, Johnny's old Mary, girl, I got a plan. Take me on down to see the pawn shop man. Yeah, we'll go down there and buy me a gun. We'll hit up a liquor store and have a little fun. Yeah, Tiny met the devil. Yeah, Tiny met the devil. Said, man, yeah, Johnny met the devil. Yeah, Johnny met the devil. Yeah, Johnny met the devil for the price of the bullet. Yeah, Johnny met the devil for the price of the bullet. Yeah. devil for the price of the bullet. I hit every now and then, just wouldn't cut it. Yeah, dreaming out of reach, you just couldn't grab it. Johnny met the devil with $100 habit. Yeah, Johnny met the devil. Yeah, Johnny met the devil. Yeah, Johnny met the devil for the price of the bullet. Yeah, Johnny met the devil for the price of the bullet. Yeah, Johnny met the devil for the price of the bullet. Shape I'm in, I can't sing, I ain't pretty, and my legs out thin. And don't ask me what I think of you, might not give the answer that you want me to. We'll be right back. Said it under the stance and stick by me, I'll be your guiding hand. And don't ask me what to think of you. Might not give the answer that you want me to. Thank you.
Now, but we really want to thank the fans.
We want to thank the fans. Thank you guys so much.
You guys don't realize how much we're always thinking about you guys.
We're going to try and put on a hell of a show tonight for you guys, and we're going to videotape it, and we're going to record it, and then we'll see what we do with it after that.
And the next album's for you guys. So
the next album is in the works. Thank you guys so much.
See ya.
Now he's using it to hide the bruises on her cheek.